Hello, dear ones. Father Peter John coming to you from All Saints Orthodox Church in Bloomington, Indiana, on the Sunday after Theophany. Christ is in our midst. I want to talk today briefly about the gospel reading. It was actually a very short gospel reading from St. Matthew, and it ends with this, with these simple words, that Jesus, after he had heard that John the Baptist had been arrested, he withdrew to Capernaum, and he, it says that he began to preach, saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." Now, it's interesting because this takes place, this is on the Sunday, as I said, after Theophany. So this is the beginning, it marks the beginning of Jesus' earthly ministry. And how does he begin that ministry? He begins the ministry in the same way that John the Baptist had preached. He begins by saying, "Repent." What does it mean to repent? To repent literally means, it's the Greek word metanoia, it means to change your mind, to turn around, to change your way of thinking, to reorient yourself toward God. So it's a very important action, actually, this process of repentance. It's an action. It's something that it's important for God that we do it in order that we can be forgiven and that we can be in communion with him. And it's just something that I wanted to say because, you know, it's so easy, especially in our current climate, where everybody is so hyper-focused on this person doing that and this person doing that. And, you know, politics has its place and people will figure out if this person broke the law, did that person break, how did all of this stuff work? And it'll play out in the political arena. That's what happens. But it's important for us not to get so swept up into that kind of way of doing things where everybody is just crashing down, they're taking sides, and, you know, that's not how it's supposed to be in the church. I mean, except for in the councils, of course, where you've got the heresy that comes in, and then you've got the church, the Orthodox, that have to defend it, and it ends up being this kind of a black and white process to determine, you know, what the church has always believed and maintain that. And then present that going forward. But that's not what we're talking about here. We're not talking about heresy within the church or something like that. Society right now is hyper-focused on political matters. And so my encouragement to each and every one of us is, while those political things work themselves out as they do and as they will, that we not get so drawn into that that we let it be damaging to our soul, that we let it be a destructive force on our spiritual life, you know, because in our spiritual life, we're supposed to be saying, "Lord, have mercy on me. I'm the chief of sinners, and I am more sinful than my neighbor." You know, that if I'm the chief of sinners, I'm more sinful than my neighbor. And then we are supposed to put the love of God first, and then love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Whole lot in there about love. But Jesus, again, in talking about how we're supposed to treat other people, you know, he says, "He who is without sin cast the first stone." He says, "Remove the log out of your own eye before looking at the speck in your neighbor's eye." So Jesus is very clear. He is the all-merciful one. And his desire is that we would live in loving communion with him and with one another in the church. And so I just want to be encouraging in that and remind each and every one of us that as pervasive as the media coverage is on everything that's happening in Washington, D.C. and throughout the country and even throughout the world, that we not forget that our obligation is to do what Jesus told us to do. His first commandment to us was to repent, right? And then, of course, his new commandment is to love one another. So with that, God bless you and protect you. May he protect each of us and help us to remember to put him first and to act and think and desire love for our neighbor as for ourselves. Christ is in our midst. He is and ever shall be.